Everybody, it's Kayla back again with another video. Today I'm going to be talking about how to prepare for your finance interviews. I've personally interviewed for financial analyst positions in basically every finance sector that you can think of. Venture capital, investment banking, corporate finance, even a alternative investments hedge fund at one point. I've also have done interviews for wealth management firms and with financial advisors. My tips work well for all of the sectors in finance that you could be interviewing for, and I'm going to be bringing up important topics for every interview that you go on. Be sure to come back to this video after your finance interviews and let me know how my tips worked out for you. Tip number one, which is going to be regarding the most commonly asked questions and scenarios that come up during your interviews. You're going to want to do a lot of research on the most commonly asked questions based on what company you're going to be interviewing with, what sector you're interviewing in, and what position you're interviewing for. Now, there are common HR questions that are asked in every single interview, like, so tell me about yourself. Why investment banking? Why this bank? You're going to really want to practice these questions and make a compelling case for yourself and make these people who are interviewing you believe that you are the top candidate for this job. Dig deep into what sector of finance that you're interviewing in and for the individual company that you're interviewing at. This is why I recommend Wall Street Oasis to everybody watching my finance videos and everybody out there that wants a finance job, especially Wall Street level jobs. This is the time to invest in yourself. When you're going for these high-level jobs that are paying over $100,000 a year, they have curated guides for investment banking, hedge funds, private equity, consulting, etc. These are some of the most competitive jobs in the world, and you want to be properly prepared for them. Wall Street Oasis is the leading expert on getting individuals prepared for their high-level finance jobs. Give yourself the present of being fully prepared for your finance interviews. Go check out Wall Street Oasis, link down below. Tip number two, get your resume checked and your skills on point. If you haven't already gotten your resume checked, I highly suggest that you go and do that, because your resume is going to be brought up and talked about during your interview. You should know your resume by heart so you're able to sell yourself and all the experiences that you've listed on your resume and convey why those experiences matter in your journey of getting your finance job. If you listed on your resume that you're an Excel expert, you better put your money where your mouth is. Be prepared to talk about all the skills listed on your resume and for technical questions during the interview. You better know how to make financial models, know how to give effective presentations, and know how to explain important concepts. The important thing to remember is that you need to demonstrate credibility to the interviewers so that they know that they can trust you with clients, executives, any important people that you would be working with and interacting with. Tip number three, look the part. You're going to want to have an outfit picked out in advance before you go on your finance interviews. You do not want to rush the morning of or the night before a finance interview and worry about you and your look and what you're wearing when you're going to these interviews. That's not smart. You do not want to be rushing to a store last minute and having to choose whatever they have on the rack. I really recommend, especially to men, to get a tailor and make sure the outfit that you're wearing, which will most likely be a suit, to have that tailored and make sure it looks really good on you. How the clothes fit you is very important, and it's more important than you spending tons of money on an outfit. But it doesn't just end at clothes. You want to make sure your hair is neat, that your skin is looking good and blemish free. If you're a lady and you wear makeup, be sure to choose a nice, like, glow from within makeup look. Pick an appropriate perfume and cologne, nothing too overwhelming, and make sure your accessories are on point. If you need some help figuring these things out, I would recommend talking to a friend of yours whose style you admire. If you're somebody who's going for an internship interview, or you're somebody who's just starting out in their career and don't have a lot of excess money, you do not have to break the bank to make yourself look good for these interviews. If you need a haircut, go to the closest hair school to you and get a haircut. It'll be less than $10. If you need a new top, a new belt, something like that, real easy. Go to Nordstrom Rack, TJ Maxx, Marshalls, any of those kind of stores. They'll have some high quality stuff at really low prices. And remember, it's always important to invest in yourself and your look. Humans are just visual creatures, and that's the way things are. Tip number 4, body language and confidence. So you're looking good now, you know the most commonly asked questions that are gonna be thrown at you during these interviews, but if your confidence and your body language is lacking, then that's a big turnoff to interviewers. I recommend that everybody go and do some research on body language and what your body language is conveying to others. I actually really love Higher Status by Jason Capital. It's an awesome book. Everybody should read it. And I also really like The Definitive Guide of Body Language. Now for confidence, you need to feel good about yourself and this opportunity that you could be going and earning yourself at this interview. Let me tell you right now, if you do not believe in yourself, nobody else is gonna believe in you. Some of you have doubts about your abilities for any number of reasons. Everyone has had doubts about themselves at one point in their life. It's just human nature. I'm telling you right now, cut it out and focus on the task on hand. Do not allow a lack of confidence to affect you at your finance interviews. This lack of confidence shows through and people can read you like a book. People do not want to be hiring people with lack of confidence. Do what you need to do to increase your confidence, whether that's buying new clothes, practice your interview questions, talk to a mentor about any issues that you're going through, follow your gut and ask for help regarding confidence issues. But most of all, believe in yourself. Tip number 5, mock interviews. If you've never done a mock interview before, I definitely recommend that you go and do some with various people. Sometimes you're unaware that you have poor body language or that a lack of confidence is coming through or that you're answering questions in an odd manner. Bonus points if you're able to do these mock interviews with people who are also finance majors or financial professionals already out in the field. This is why mock interviews are so important. You're able to get critiqued and make adjustments to your behavior, to your body language, and so on. If you're still at university, most career centers have people there who will do mock interviews with you. So be sure to take advantage of being near a career center and getting a mock interview done. It's definitely worth the time to do so. Now, if you're not still in college or you don't live around the college that you graduated from, it doesn't hurt to ask your friends and family to give that mock interview. Of course, it's preferable to have somebody in finance to give you the interview or somebody who has experience doing lots of mock interviews and has experience giving feedback on these kinds of things. Tip number 6, ask your interviewer questions. So you go through the interview, you're answering the questions being asked of you with flying colors, but if you're not asking interesting and introspective questions to the people interviewing you, that can be a major ding against you. This is when background research comes in handy. Do background research, obviously, on the company that you're interviewing at. Read any news articles that might have come up about the company that you're interviewing at. If you know in advance who you're interviewing with, do a LinkedIn search on them, see where they went to school, what positions they previously held, what they specialize in. I'm not saying to go and stalk these people on Facebook. That's not a smart idea. By asking strategic questions, you will learn a ton about the role that you're interviewing for, about the people you'd be working with, the projects that you'd be working on, and what a typical day looks like at whatever company that you're interviewing at. Asking these strategic questions shows that you've done your background research. It will show that you've taken the time to take this opportunity seriously. And asking questions shows that it was important for you to show up to this interview with things to talk about and that you know your stuff. Few other candidates truly master this, and by asking strategic questions, you stand out amongst the competition. Tip number 7, not every company is going to be a fit. This is probably some of the best advice I can give to the people watching this video right now, is that not every company is going to be a good fit for you, and you're not always going to be a good fit for every single company. You just don't know if it's going to be a fit until you actually go through the interview. These interviews will most definitely make you a stronger person and give you a lot of knowledge regarding finance, more about yourself and where you want to go in life, what sector you want to work in, etc. Sometimes the most promising opportunities turn out to be duds, and sometimes what seems to be a dud actually turns out to be a really good opportunity. It's better to know in advance that you could have ended up with a horrible boss, terrible teammates, or been expected to sleep underneath your desk for multiple nights a week. Take these experiences to help you find the position that would be a better match for you and make you feel more fulfilled. So those were my tips, guys. Be sure to let me know if these tips helped you out. And if they did, be sure to give this video a like. If you know someone who is going for finance interviews or is interested in working in finance, be sure to share this video with them. If you have any comments or questions, be sure to leave them down below. If you haven't already checked out Wall Street Oasis, I'm telling you, it's in your best interest. Go check it out. It's the best and most complete resource that can get you prepared for your finance interviews and make you stand out amongst the candidates. Link down below. You're gonna thank me later. And if you're not already subscribed to me, you should definitely hit that subscribe button down below. Until next time, I'll see you around in another one of my videos. Bye.